Fontainebleau is scheduled to open by the end of 2023.
Yeah, I'll believe that when I see it.
Is the Ace of Vegas, the Ace of Vegas.
Before we get started, I just wanted to give a special shout out to our Patreon members that help keep us independent and growing. More on that later.
Hey there, Spinners and Sharks, Ace of Vegas here, and I hope you're doing well. So I'm sure by now you guys have noticed that there's a new casino hotel project on the Las Vegas Strip. Well, it's an old one, but I guess what's old is new again. The project is the Fontainebleau Las Vegas, aka the Drew, aka the Marriott Las Vegas Boulevard, aka the Big Blue Eyesore.
Also known as aka Horse Choker, aka Pillsbury Doughboy.
Jokes aside, the Fontainebleau has been through a lot of hands, a lot of name changes, and a lot of scrutiny over the past 15 years. The project has been through about 3 or 4 owners, 2 or 3 name changes, and started and stopped construction just as many times over the years. So it makes you wonder, is this project ever gonna come to fruition? And as much as I hate to be a cynic about it, I'm a little skeptical about Fontainebleau actually finishing the job for once. So before we discuss why Fontainebleau probably won't be finished by 2023, let me give you an abridged history of the project so that you guys understand why I don't believe in it.
Originally, the Fontainebleau Las Vegas project, its original name, which it has since reverted to, was conceived back in May of 2005. Originally planned to open in 2008, construction would stop briefly after topping out the 67-story tower due to the Great Recession of 2008. The construction was officially put on hold in June 2009 after a few threats of lawsuits by the banks that were funding the project. Fast forward about 10 years after Carl Icahn had bought the project from Fontainebleau out of bankruptcy court, Witkoff Investments took over and renamed the project The Drew after Steve Witkoff's late son, Andrew. Construction started again, then stopped abruptly in 2020 due to the Great Las Vegas Shutdown of 2020, aka the C-19 pandemic, aka Ace's 30th birthday. A year later, Fontainebleau's Jeff Sofer repurchased the project in a joint venture with Marriott International. Then, after that, The Drew was renamed the Marriott Las Vegas Boulevard. But now, in November 2021, for some inexplicable reason, the project has reverted to the original name and the original plans for the Fontainebleau Las Vegas.
So if you're not exhausted by listening to that convoluted mess of corporate crap, you must be an executive that's invested in this project, and therefore, you cannot be helped.
Regardless, things should be looking up for the Fontainebleau. It's creating not only construction jobs, but competition for the nearby resorts, and another 6,000 permanent positions on the property itself. The economy has theoretically bounced back considerably since the crash in 2008, and the other one in 2020.
So why all the skepticism? Well, it's just because we've heard it all before.
We've heard about the jobs, we've heard that there's going to be a casino, we've had a groundbreaking. Doing it all again isn't terribly convincing, especially after 15 years. Like, seriously, look at this groundbreaking. They don't even get the real dirt from the site. Which makes sense, because the tower is fully constructed and has been for 12 years.
You see what I mean? You see how that sounds? It's really, really close to what we've been hearing before. I mean, the opening date alone has been 2008, and 2009, and 2020, and 2022. And unlike Resorts World, there hasn't been a single trailer, rendering, or plan released to the public to back up the hype. So honestly, I'll be astonished if we even get a look at the property before December 2023. Nevertheless, get the full property. And not to be a complete pessimist, I really do like the idea of the Fontainebleau. It offers more competition to higher-end properties towards the north side of the Strip, like Venetian, The Wynn, Palazzo, and Resorts World. And honestly, I'm kinda hyped about the hotel itself. I want another 8-acre pool complex to hang out in. I want another 100,000 square foot gaming space to game in. I'd love to see another 3,700 rooms to stay in. I am all about the cool blue luxury that is the Fontainebleau. And frankly, I want to see that Fontainebleau Miami luxury with a Las Vegas twist on it. That's just what I think. But until I see something concrete that isn't 67 stories tall and missing a bunch of glass in there, all I have for the project is skepticism. And the Fontainebleau itself will only ever be a big blue reminder of the consequences of unfettered ambition until it actually opens, assuming it actually does. Until then, we'll just have to wait and see.
Alright, spinners and sharks, that's it for today's video. If you enjoyed today's episode and found it informative, I'd appreciate a like. And consider subscribing if you haven't already. Just real fast, I wanted to give another quick shout out to my Patreon members. Guys, as you already know, it means the world to me that you choose to support me in this way and keep me independent of the fluctuating YouTube algorithm and its ad rates. If you'd like a more direct hand in keeping Ace of Vegas independent, then I have a link to the Patreon page in the description box down below. So while we're here, what do you guys think of the new Fountain Blue project? Is it a grand slam, or is the big blue eyesore gonna stand there unfinished till time immemorial? Whatever your thoughts may be, I'd love to hear them in the comments down below. Until next time though, this is Ace of Vegas, signing off, wishing you strong hands, and of course, happy spinning, you guys.
Viva Ace of Vegas. Viva Ace of Vegas. Viva Ace of Vegas. Viva.